So we were discussing about the classful IP addressing. So I told you there are five classes. We have class A, we have class B, we have class C, class D, and we have class E. So in case of class A, the first bit is fixed, that is 0 out of complete 32 bits. That's from here to here, we have total 32 bits. The first bit is fixed as 0, and the rest, total 31 bits are remaining. Total 31 bits are remaining. Now, in case of class B, the first 2 bits are fixed, that is 1, 0, and the rest 30 bits can take any combination. In case of class C, the first 3 bits are fixed, that is 110, and the rest 29 bits can take any combination. In case of class D, the first 4 bits are fixed, that is 1110, and the rest 28 bits can take any combination. And in case of class A, the first 4 bits are fixed and the rest 28 bits can take any combination. So from this you can see, in case of class A, we are going to have a total 2^31 IP addresses. In class B, we are going to have 2^30 IP addresses. In class C, we are going to have 2^29 IP addresses. In case of class D, we are going to have 2^28 IP addresses. In case of class E, we are going to have 2^28 IP addresses. And we use a dotted decimal representation to represent these IP addresses. So first of all, let us take the class A. Let us discuss about the class A IP address. Now, in case of class A IP address, the complete IP address is divided into 2 parts. That is the network ID, net ID, and the host ID, the host ID. So the network ID is of 8 bits, and the remaining bits are used for host ID. Therefore, the host ID will be of 24 bits. In total, we have 32 bits. In total, we have 32 bits. Okay. In all these 8 bits, the first bit is fixed as 0. The first bit is fixed as 0. Right? So you can say the first bit is fixed as 0 in the first octet, and the remaining 7 bits can take any combination, and these are the host connected with this. So with these 7 bits, these are representing the network ID, that means what network it is, right? So these 7 bits are representing network ID. Therefore, there are 128, which is equal to 2^7 networks are possible, which is 128. And in every network, we are going to have 2^24 hosts. What does that mean? What do I mean when I say network and hosts? See, we can have multiple networks. For example, this is a network. This is your college network, right? This is a network which is a company network, internal company, MNC, or any company network, right? This is some personal network. And these networks, we are going to have multiple hosts which are connected. The host can be anything. The host can be a laptop, it can be a mobile phone, it can be a AC, which is nowadays ACs are also connected using internet. It can be different devices which are connected to internet. All these devices are called as host. Again, with these networks, within this network, we are going to have multiple hosts. Within this network, we are going to have multiple hosts. So this is a network, this is a network, this is a network. When I'm saying network ID, the network ID is used to identify the network. That means what network it is. For example, if we have three networks, then we can represent these three networks with two bits only. But here, in case of class A, 8 bits are used for network ID, and in all those 8 bits, the first bit is already fixed. That is, remaining bits are 7 bits, and with these 7 bits, we can have 2^7 different combinations. That means we can have 2^7 different networks like this. We can have 2^7 different networks like this. And when we discuss about the host, host means within this network, how many hosts are connected. For example, in your personal home-based system, let us suppose your Wi-Fi is acting as a connecting device. Then in your system, at your location, maybe your mobile phone is connected to this network, maybe your computer or laptop is connected to this network, and all these mobile phones and laptops are acting as a host. So within one network, how many hosts are connected? So when I say class A, in case of class A, there can be 2^7 networks, that is 128, and in every network, there can be 2^24 hosts, which are kind of practically impossible because we cannot have 2^24 hosts because this is a very big number, right? It's a very big number. Okay, so it is kind of practically impossible, or so we generally don't use a class A in real world practice. Either it can be military network, maybe in military network we can have this kind of these many hosts, but as of now, this no one is using these many hosts. Therefore, class A IP addresses are kind of, you are wasting so many hosts within one network. Okay, so these are connected with each other. These networks are connected with each other, maybe like this. This greater internet. So in case of class A, again, 7 bits, we can take any combination. We can have 2^28 hosts. In every host, so it's 2^28 networks. In every network, there are 2^24 hosts. Now, when we discuss about the class B IP address, when we discuss about the class B IP address, in case of class B IP address, out of total 32 bits, 16 bits can be used for network ID, and rest 16 bits can be used for host ID. That means we can have 2^16 networks, and we can have in every network, we can have 2^16 hosts. We can have 2^16 hosts, which are somewhere roughly around 64,000. Somewhere roughly around, we have 64,000 networks and we have 64,000 hosts in every network. Okay. Now, let me tell this again. In class B, the IP address is starting from, sorry, this is not exactly 2^16. Let me repeat again. In class B, 2 bits are fixed. 2 bits are fixed. That means out of the first 16 bits, the first 2 bits are 10, which are fixed, and the remaining 14 bits, and the remaining 14 bits can take any combination. So total 16 bits are there for the network ID, and here total 16 bits are there for the host ID. So we can have 2^14 networks in case of class B, where the first 2 bits are 10. Now, if you represent this by a dotted decimal representation, then can you tell what class it is? For example, let us suppose if I give you an IP address like this, it is 64.128.54.96. Can you tell me what IP address this IP address belong to, which class? Is it a class A IP address? Is it a class B IP address? Is it a class C IP address? Or is it a class D IP address? Okay, so we can identify that by using the first octet. That is, here the first octet is representing 64. Now you come back to the class A. Then class A, you know that out of the first 8 bits, the first bit is fixed as 0 and the next 7 bits can take any combination. Then what are the different combinations which are possible? So with this, you can see, with this, the first combination can be 0000000. The octet can take 8 zeros. Next combination can be 0000001. Next combination can be 0000010, up to so on, 0000111111. That means the first is representing 0, second number is representing 1, third number is representing 2, up to so on, the last number is representing 127. Last number is representing 127. That means, what do I mean to say by this is, every IP address will be represented in dotted decimal representation. Dotted decimal, that is octet of 8 bits. Octet itself is representing 8 bits. But all these 32 bits we are going to represent in four octets, and every octet is going to contain 8 bits. So total we will be having 32 bits. In case of class A, in the first octet, for example, the complete IP address can be like this: 0110111110.0101010.1110.1101, like this. This can be 32 bit. In this 32 bit, if the first bit is fixed as 0, that means this IP address belongs to the class A. Now, if the first bit is fixed at 0, then the first octet, this complete first octet, will be having a value between 0 to 127. 0 to 127. The first value can be 0 and the last value can be 127. So, if in an IP address, the first octet is representing a value between 0 to 127, that means the IP address belongs to the class A. So, here the IP address is 64.128.54.96. In this complete IP address, the first bit is the first octet is representing 64, and this 64 belongs between 0 to 127. Therefore, this IP address is there for the class A. This IP address belongs to the class A. Now, if you discuss about the class B IP address, in case of class B IP address, the first two bits are fixed as 10, and the next rest six in the first octet, the rest six bits can take any combination. See, there are two things. One, I am saying that this is representing a network ID. That means first 16 bits are representing a network ID, and here the first 8 bits are representing a network ID. Network ID is different and octet is different. Octet is just the combination of 8 bits. So we represent the complete IP address with a combination of 8 bits. Now, if you have an IP address like this, 10111100.1101110.1111100.1111000. Now, in this complete IP address, the first two bits, they are fixed as 10. The first two bits are fixed as 10. Because the first two bits are fixed as 10, therefore this IP address belongs to the class B. This IP address belongs to class B. And this IP address can have some value. And what are those values? That means, what are the values which this IP address can take? What are the possible values which this first octet can take? What are the values the first octet can take? So, in this first octet can take a value which is 10000000 to 10000001. To up to so on 10111111. It is representing a value 128, it is representing value 129, and this one is representing a value which is 191, So if an IP address, the first octet of an IP address is like this: 129.156.122.234. Now, here the first octet is representing a value which is 129, and this 129 belongs between 128 to 191. Therefore, this IP address is in class B. That means, in case of class A, the first octet will be having a value between 0 to 127. In class B, the first octet will be having a value 128 to 191. Right. Now, again, in case of class C, we can find this kind of value that we will be finding in the next video. Okay. So, as of now, just remember that if the first octet is having a value between 128 to 191, that means it is a class B IP address. Okay. So, let us continue with the next video.